What is happening? Happiness is happening.
Wow.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, everybody. All right. All right. Okay.
It's so nice to meet you. I'm fascinated by this because you got into gardening. You weren't really a gardener, but you were kind of helping someplace else. Uh-huh. Then you find an abandoned lot, and you somehow transform that into a 13,000-square-foot garden.
Yeah.
How did you... I mean, there's so much to learn. What did you have to do in order to make that happen?
Well, I had to learn a whole lot real fast. All right, so basically, I was sitting down minding my business at another garden. My elder, Hernan Pagan, told me there was a garden I was being abused, neglected around the corner. I was in disbelief, but I walked over anyway, and there was this giant place that was full of years of trash, like layer on layer on layer, like a lasagna of debris. And I felt sad, but I was like, this is a neighborhood that needs a garden, needs green space. So I got with him and some of the neighbors, and we started just kind of like brainstorming, how do we turn this lot into a thriving garden? And so we just got busy, got some shovels, some trash bags, and got to work.
Yeah, but that's, and then you have to learn how to actually put the right things in, and fertilizer, and garden, and all of that.
Oh, yes, I make up a lot of stuff as I go along. I had no idea, but just from talking with like elders and neighbors, I had to learn things I should not know. Like right now, I'm an amateur electrician, I'm an amateur plumber, I'm like a mid-level carpenter. But yeah, these things I had to do to get this space up and running for my neighborhood.
Yeah, and so why was this so important to you to create this garden?
Well, I live in Bushwick, Brooklyn, and it's an area that has really been neglected in terms of food, the environment. And what I did was I knew that the garden could be a vehicle towards social justice, towards racial justice, towards environmental justice. And I just wanted to have that place be special in my neighborhood. So the why for me was I wanted to change the trajectory of my neighborhood.
And you have.
Thank you, man.
You have. For people who don't know what a food desert is, explain, because that's where you live. Explain what a food desert is.
Of course. So a food desert, or sometimes referred to as a food, like a food apartheid, is there are places in our country where there is not access to healthy food, organic food, food without pesticides. And when something like that happens, you're actually denying a whole population access to a healthy life. And so what I want to do is try to change our access, our availability, our lifestyles, and the health of my whole community.
And it's so important because, like, you know, there are no grocery stores that have vegetables or fruits. They just have fast food, and it's only going to make people sick, only going to make people unhealthy. And the fact that you're growing this and serving so many people, how many people have you, I mean, it's been tons and tons of food, right?
Yes, yes. To date, we have distributed more than 14 tons of fresh, free, organic food to the hood.
Amazing. All right. We're going to take a break. More with Kofi after this. We are back with the founder of the Good Life Garden, Kofi Thomas. So how do you get funding for all this? This is not a cheap thing.
Yes, honestly, I do not know. I get very creative. I just do really whatever I have to do to raise money for the things that we need. Like, I take on odd jobs, handyman moving, I'll hang your curtains. Like, whatever I got to do to get money to buy the seeds and soil that we need, I do it.
That's fantastic. All right, well, I love what you do. I really do. This season, I have partnered with a company called TisBest, and they want to help you continue to serve your community, so they want to give you a check for $20,000.
No way! Stop paying! What? What the hell is up to? Do we hold it?
Yeah.
Oh, what is happening? Yeah. What is happening? What is happening?
All right, and have a seat. TisBest charity gift cards are a better gift for any occasion, so they also want to give you a $5,000 gift card to donate to any charity of your choice.
What is another one? What is happening? Where did these people come from?
To experience the true power of giving, visit TisBest.org. I want to thank Catherine Hahn, Candace Parker. I want to thank all of you for watching. Thanks for being a part of my final season. I feel the love in this room. I give it back to you. Spread it in the world.